Welcome to celebrate the Holy Eucharist that is the source and summit of our Christian life. Today, as we celebrate the third Sunday of Lent, Father Angel will offer the Holy Mass for Mary Ann Mahar. There are a few announcements. There is Eucharistic Adoration this Monday. The Parish Council is happy to announce we will be having St. Patrick's Dinner at the Newfane site on Saturday, March 18th. This is a potluck following the 4 p.m. Mass. Please bring a dish to pass. If you'd like to help with setup, we will begin after Stations of the Cross on March 17th. The St. Joseph's Table will be on Sunday, March 19th, at the Wilson site. Volunteers are needed for St. Joseph's Table. Contact Carol Hartwig to volunteer. Are you looking for an opportunity to enhance your spiritual life and enjoy fellowship with others from around Western New York? Please consider attending the 21st Annual Catholic Men's Conference of Western New York, which will take place on March 25th at Cardinal O'Hara High School, or the Catholic Women's Conference on April 29th at St. Joseph's Collegiate. Please visit thebuffalodiocese.org for more information. On Monday, the St. Brennan seniors will have their monthly meeting beginning at 10 a.m. Subs and Sundays will be served at a cost of $5. Remember that tonight we put our clocks ahead 1 hour. Please help to remind each other. For further information on these and other important events, they are listed in the church bulletin. Now please rise.
Our opening hymn is number 397, Tree of Life, number 397.
Tree of life and awesome mystery, in your death we are reborn. Though you die in all of history, still you rise with every morn. Still you rise with every morn. Seed that dies to rise in glory, may we see ourselves in you. If we learn to live your story, we may die to rise anew. We may die to rise anew. We remember truth unspoken, love passed on through act and word. Every person lost and broken, where's the body of our Lord? Where's the body of our Lord?
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen. Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. It's one of my favorite mentors once, or was known for saying when he would begin Mass, Monsignor Lorenzetti. Some of us might be familiar with him. He's the oldest priest now, I believe now 102 years old. But his spirit is as young as it always was. He would always say, look at all of these beautiful people who have come tonight of their own volition to celebrate the Lord's mysteries. It's a beautiful sight when I turn the corner, seeing a full church and really putting into practice what our gospel talks about today. People thirsting for the living water of God. And we know that it was our thirst for God, our desire for God, that has brought us together and has brought us here. A little while ago, I was at All Saints working with RCIA, the candidates and catechumens, those who are working to join the Catholic faith, but you know, from all of the parishes of our family. And just a great and beautiful sight when we see people thirsting for God, hungering for God, and hungering for that communion and coming of their own volition to seek it. So may this beautiful thing that we have going continue to be built up. And as we prepare for the celebration, we call to mind our sins. We call to mind times maybe we have saddened our God, saddened the communion that we have with each other, with our selfishness or with our hurt, and we ask for our God's mercy and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, and what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints,
and you, my brothers and sisters,
to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, author of every mercy and of all goodness, who in fasting, prayer, and almsgiving have shown us a remedy for sin, look graciously on this confession of our lowliness, that we who are bowed down by our conscience may always be lifted up by your mercy, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, in their thirst for water, the people grumbled against Moses, saying, "Why did you ever make us leave Egypt? Was it just to have us die here of thirst with our children and our livestock?" So Moses cried out to the Lord, "What shall I do with this people? A little more, and they will stone me." The Lord answered Moses, "Go over there in front of the people, along with some of the elders of Israel, holding in your hand, as you go, the staff with which you struck the river. I will be standing there in front of you on the rock of Oreb. Strike the rock, and the water will flow from it for the people to drink." This Moses did in the presence of the elders of Israel. The place was called Massah and Meribah, because the Israelites quarreled there and tested the Lord, saying, "Is the Lord in our midst or not?" The word of the Lord.
Today you would hear his voice, harden not.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, since we have been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith to this grace in which we stand, and we boast in hope of the glory of God. And hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit, who has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person. Though perhaps for a good person, one might even find courage to die. But God proves his love for us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. The word of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Lord, you are truly the Savior of the world. Give me living water that I may never thirst again. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus came to a town of Samaria called Sychar, near the plot of land that Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there. Jesus, tired from his journey, sat down there at the well. It was about noon. A woman of Samaria came to draw water. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." His disciples had gone into the town to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "How can you, a Jew, ask me, a Samaritan woman, for a drink? For Jews use nothing in common with Samaritans." Jesus answered and said to her, "If you knew the gift of God and who was saying to you, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." The woman said to him, "Sir, you do not even have a bucket, and the cistern is deep. Where can you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us this cistern and drank from it himself with his children and his flocks?" Jesus answered and said to her, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again, but whoever drinks the water I shall give will never thirst. The water that I shall give will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water that I may not be thirsty or have to keep coming here to draw water." Jesus said to her, "Go call your husband and come back." The woman answered and said to him, "I do not have a husband." Jesus said, "You are right in saying, 'I do not have a husband,' for you have had five husbands, and the one you have now is not your husband. What you have said is true." The woman said to him, "Sir, I can see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worshipped on this mountain, but you people say that the place to worship is in Jerusalem." Jesus said to her, "Believe me, woman, the hour is coming when you will worship the Father neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You people worship what you do not understand. We worship what we understand, because salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming, and is now here, when true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth. And indeed, the Father seeks such people to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. The woman said to him, I know that the Messiah is coming, the one called the Christ. When he comes, he will tell us everything. Jesus said to her, I am he, the one speaking with you. At that moment, his disciples returned and were amazed at what he was talking with the woman about. But still no one said, what are you looking for? Or why are you talking with her? The woman left her water jar and came into the town and said to the people, come and see a man who told me everything that I have done. Could he possibly be the Christ? They went out of the town and came to him. Meanwhile, the disciples urged him, Rabbi, eat. He said to them, I have food to eat of which you do not know. So the disciples said to one another, could someone have brought him something to eat? Jesus said, my food is to do the will of the one who sent me and to finish his work. Do not say, in 4 months the harvest will be here. I tell you, look up and see the fields ripe for the harvest. The reaper is already receiving payment and gathering the crops for eternal life, so that the sower and the reaper can rejoice together. For here the saying is verified that the one who one sows and another reaps. I say to you, reap what you have not worked for. Others have done the work, and you are sharing the fruits of their work. Many of the Samaritans of that town began to believe in him because of the word of the woman who testified, he told me everything I have done. When the Samaritans came to him, they invited him to stay with them, and he stayed there 2 days. Many more began to believe in him because of his word. And they said to the woman, we no longer believe because of your word, for we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this truly is the Savior of the world. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I can definitely relate very well to that situation of Jesus. Jesus took on our being, you know, like us, humanity in all ways, and everything but sin, including being thirsty, including being tired. And here he was, tired from a journey, sitting at the well. Now, as we know, we hear that it was about noon, very hot in that part of the world. I remember being a kid, whenever we'd be out with my parents, even if it was a fun place where we were, I would get tired and hot, you know, and thirsty very easily. I remember one day in particular where I could really relate to, at least in part, relate to what Jesus was feeling when I was with my parents at Darien Lake. It was about maybe 5, 6 years old at the time, having a very enjoyable day. But of course, all that walking for a young kid could get tiring, especially in the heat. And boy, would I get thirsty, especially if I was walking around a lot and it was very hot and I'd dry out. And so, you know, the children's part of the park, I remember I was there with my dad in line to get on one of the rides. And I just was so thirsty. I was so thirsty, you know, standing in line waiting and like, oh, I can't wait till the next chance that I can have a drink or see a water fountain around. And then I see what I thought looked just like a water fountain. And I'm like, okay, an answer to my prayers, water fountain is here. I learned a few minutes later what I thought was a water fountain was actually the control for the ride. So there, you know, the attendant is helping, you know, one of the children on. I forgot exactly what the ride was. I think it was those airplanes that just go around in a circle and, you know, raise up and down. And my dad is holding my hand and watching, you know, the ride, watching the kids get on. And then all of a sudden sees the attendant, you know, yelling, "No, no, don't touch that," and turns as the ride starts up, starts moving without her, you know, hitting the button. It's there I am. It was me. I thought, to me, the thing looked just like a water fountain. I was really hot, really thirsty, and, you know, it had like this big metal key that would that looked just like a faucet. I thought the button is there. That's what it does. And it's a story my parents will never let me forget. But when we're that thirsty, sometimes, you know, anything that looks like it could possibly be a fountain, you know, really jumps out at us. But we've all been, I'm sure, especially on hot days, you know, really thirsty, really in need of something to satisfy our longing. And it almost sounds like it's too good to be true when Jesus is saying that, you know, in your hunger and in your thirst, I give you something that you could drink that won't leave you thirsty again. And very often on those really hot days, taking a little drink, little swig of water helps us out for a while, but it's not long at all before we're thirsty again. But Jesus used earthly familiar thirst, regular water that satisfies our thirst, as a beginning, as a way of whetting our appetite to then get our hopes and our sights fixed on something that would satisfy us even better, that would satisfy us in a way that we would never be left thirsty again. And he's telling us, have thirst, have longing, have desire for those things that will last. Doing the will of God, he tells us, is how we access, how we get to, and how we even continue to prime our hunger for the things of eternity. I know a lot of us might be familiar with the world of investments, and some of us might be avid investors ourselves. Maybe we do that personally or with our companies that we work for, and we know that we want to make investments that will have a good return with longevity, investments that will keep giving. Sometimes investments might have a very good return, but it's short-lived, and once it's done, it's done. All of us need to be mindful more and more that we have an earthly beginning, but our soul will live in eternity, either in the preferable part of eternity or the other part that is not so preferable. So it's up to us to be putting our sights on the things of heaven, realizing that the greatest things that our soul longs for are things that are only gift from God and nothing that we could ever procure or earn on our own. So knowing, being very familiar with hunger, being familiar with thirst, let us do the will of our God so that we may access the true living water by which we never thirst again, the bread of eternal life, which feeds us for eternity, brings us to eternal life where we would never hunger again. May all of our appetites, all of our longings be oriented around that. And may we also be ready to do away with anything that might satisfy us, but not in a good way. You know, things that will only leave us hungry again, or things that will, you know, prevent us from hungering and truly longing for the things of eternal life that our God wants to give us. Knowing that what our God speaks of today is something that we could never earn again, may we seek the things of our God with ever more grateful hearts and always be ready to reap the harvest that he sends our way. Together, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made,
consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds with the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Grateful that our God wishes to satisfy our deepest longings and to provide us with abundant blessings that even for eternity may satisfy our needs, we now come before our God humbly asking for what we need today.
Our response today is, Christ our hope, hear our prayer. For the church, that we may be a source of living water for all who thirst for purpose and meaning in their lives, we pray to the Lord. Christ our hope, hear our prayer. For all who thirst every day, that God will assist all who have limited access to water, guide all who are searching for new sources of water, and raise our awareness of the importance of protecting clean water, we pray to the Lord. Christ our hope, hear our prayer. For all the elect, that they may grow in their desire for waters of new birth and surrender to God more fully this Lent, we pray to the Lord. Christ our hope, hear our prayer. For all who are ill, especially John Johnson, Cindy Chapman, Kim McKenna, John Lebazowski Sr., Karen Kruger, Caitlin Safrano, David Crawford, Don Blecki, Joseph Guido, Jeffrey Antonick, that God will touch their bodies and spirits with tenderness and healing love. We pray to the Lord. Christ our hope, hear our prayer. For all who have died, especially Lawrence Hart, our faithfully departed, we pray to the Lord. Christ our hope, hear our prayer. For Mary Ann Mahar, for whom this Eucharist is being offered, we pray to the Lord. Christ our hope, hear our prayer. For all of us gathered here at St. Brendan on the Lake, and for families of all public and private schools, including DeSales Catholic School, that we, like Abraham, may go forth from all that is familiar to new places into which God leads us, so that we may be a blessing to others. We pray to the Lord.
Christ our hope, hear our prayer.
Our needs and petitions that we bring before you today, we ask that you grant them through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Our hymn during the offertory is number 502, Come to the Water, number 502.
Except for the Lord.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all of his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with these sacrificial offerings, and grant that we who beseech pardon for our sins may take care to forgive our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For when he asked the Samaritan woman for water to drink, he had already created the gift of faith within her, and so ardently did he thirst for her faith that he kindled in her the fire of divine love. And so we too give you thanks, and with the angels we praise your mighty deeds as we acclaim. You therefore, Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come,
Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, We offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also, together with your Son, and in this saving banquet graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. May he keep us in communion with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all the bishops and your entire people. And just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all of the saints, and with our brothers and sisters and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed
be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us
our trespasses,
as we forgive
those who trespass against us.
And lead us
not into temptation,
but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Our hymn during the communion will be number 821, Bread of Life, Hope of the World, number 821.
For those unable to attend Mass in person to receive the Eucharist, I invite you to pray an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Give us life, lead us to
Let us pray. Sorry. As we receive the pledge of things yet hidden in heaven and are nourished while still on earth with the bread that comes from on high, we humbly entreat you, O Lord, that what is being brought about to us in mystery may come to true completion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just don't. So you may have noticed how, as a family of parishes, we have a little bit of a different Easter schedule. There is a pastoral message that's been asked to be read at all of the masses throughout the family, or all of the parishes throughout the family, indicating that one of the initiatives of the Road to Renewal is for the family of parishes to celebrate major events and liturgies together. This is necessitated by the fact that we will have fewer priests than the number of parishes within each family. The most important week in the life of a Christian is Holy Week, and the most important liturgy is the Triduum, that is Holy Thursday, Good Friday, and Holy Saturday's most solemn vigil. The priest of our central Niagara Catholic family considered our options, and we came up with a schedule that ensures that all parishes will host a liturgy during these days. Each year going forward, the different events will rotate so that all will host the different events over the course of the 4 years. And this is the only equitable path forward. The schedule for this year is that on Palm Sunday, we'll have the normal Sunday schedule. All Saints and Immaculate Conception will celebrate morning prayer on Holy Thursday, Good Friday, and Holy Saturday. The Mass of the Lord's Supper on Holy Thursday will be held at All Saints at 7 p.m., followed by the reposition of the Blessed Sacrament until midnight in their chapel. The Liturgy of the Lord's Passion on Good Friday will be held here at 3 p.m., and on Good Friday in the evening, Immaculate Conception will host the solemn Stations of the Cross. And then the solemn Vigil of Easter on Holy Saturday will be at St. John the Baptist at 8:30. And a reminder that there are no other Masses on Holy Saturday. So that's standard everywhere. So funerals and other things can't be scheduled on those days. The Easter Sunday Mass schedule will be like a Sunday at each parish. While we know that this change may be unsettling, it should be seen as a way to celebrate our salvation in Christ in a new way with great numbers of our family worshiping God together. So you could find that schedule in your bulletins. Of course, it will be different, you know, no question, but we remember that God will be at every liturgy, at every place, and we'll continue to be open to the ways that the Holy Spirit leads us forward. And in all things that we do, we continue to pray that the Holy Spirit empowers and guides them. And may the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow down for the blessing. Direct, O Lord, we pray, the hearts of your faithful, and in your kindness grant your servants this grace, that abiding in the love of you and of their neighbors, they may fulfill the whole of your commands through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Our closing hymn is number 698, Take Up Your Cross, number 698.
Take up your cross, the Savior said, if you will my disciple be, take up your cross with me.
Take up your cross and follow Christ.